Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So for today's video, I am going to be doing another rankings video. It's been a while since I've done one of these. If you aren't familiar with this series on my channel, basically whatever category of products I am ranking, I rank them from my least to my most favorite. So today I am going to be ranking my Anastasia Beverly Hills palettes. So if you're excited to see what my least to most favorite palettes are, then just keep watching. So I've said this before, but I think Anastasia does the best job of palette layouts, one of the best in the business. I think their color stories are amazing. I think that they're so unique. The color stories and the color layouts that go in their palettes really make it user-friendly and it really inspire me as an artist to create really beautiful looks. So for that reason, I love ABH palettes, and every time they come out with a palette, I pick it up. So I just want to preface this video by stating that even my least favorite, I still really do enjoy. I will go into further detail obviously in a second, but I love all of these palettes, so even though if they're ranked lower, I still really, really like them. For these videos, they just have to go somewhere, you know? So we're gonna start off with number 7, my least favorite of my Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. And I mean, this should come as no shock to you. This is the Subculture palette. I have to say though, of all the palettes, the color story of this is probably my favorite. But as you know, the quality was quite disappointing to a lot of people. This palette is difficult to work with, I'm not going to lie. So like I said, this color story is amazing. It is one of my favorites ever in a palette. I've created such really stunning looks with this palette. However, you have to prepare when you're going to use this palette because the powders are extremely powdery. It can get difficult to blend, and if you aren't familiar with the color wheel, your look can turn out muddy. So you have to kind of know what you're doing to be able to work with this palette. Luckily, I'm very patient. I apply very little product at a time, so I am able to make this palette work, and I do really like it and the looks I come up with. But you know what? Just to throw on, I can't use this. If I ever want to do somebody else's makeup, I'm not going to use this. So for that reason, this is the last place. But like I said, love the colors in it. The execution just wasn't up to par with ABH. All right, so on to number 6. I love this palette. I think that the color story of it is very unique, and this is such an inspiring palette. Unfortunately, you cannot get it anymore. It was limited edition, but this is the Prism palette. As you can see, it has some very unique colors. They're very different. I mean, I think initially the color story here, it can be difficult to think of looks. Like, it's just not so obvious from looking at the palette. But personally, I feel so inspired by this palette to mix colors that I wouldn't think of mixing. I love this neon shade right here, Sphere, and you can also get some really neutral wearable looks with this palette, so I find this palette to be very, very versatile. The reason it is second to last though is just because I don't reach for it quite as often as I wish I could, but every time I do use it, I do love it, and I think this is a really, really unique palette, and I can see why they made this palette limited edition. However, this is a really good palette, and they did an amazing job with this palette. So moving on to palette number 5. This, I'm very surprised that it ranked this low amongst these palettes, because initially I was very excited for this palette and thought it was going to be one of my favorites, but we have the Norvina palette. And the reason I was so excited for this palette was because it's like pinks and purples, which are my shades. I love pinks and purples. They really make my brown eyes pop. And this is such a really pretty palette. However, I just was disappointed with it because I wish it was a little bit more purple. I wish they would have been a little bit more adventurous with this color story and really go in and hone in on that purple pink vibe by adding some eggplant colors, some more matte pink colors. Just take the plunge and really make this palette truly unique. But they definitely took the safe route with it. There's a large number of neutrals in this palette that are already in a bunch of other ABH palettes. So for that reason, it is almost a waste if you are purchasing this and you do have a lot of ABH palettes, because like half this palette can be duplicated within their own line. That being said, this palette is really gorgeous, and if you do like this purple pinky look, you do have a number of fun options to get a purple and pink look. But I was more so disappointed in the fact that they weren't more adventurous with this, because I figured it was ABH and they wouldn't be afraid to. It is a pretty palette, but I just don't reach for it as often as I thought I would. So that is why that one goes to number 5. Okay, So number four, this one is the Modern Renaissance palette. This is kind of a classic for ABH. I feel like this is what really catapulted their brand into one of the best sellers. For a long time, this was a staple for everybody. This was a favorite for everybody. Personally, warm tone eyeshadows I do like. However, they aren't my go-to. I have to be in the mood for a warm look for me to go for warm shadows. I personally just prefer more neutral tones. So the fact that this palette is so very warm and very berry, I just don't reach for it as often as everybody else did. I do like it. I've created some gorgeous looks with this palette, and I actually use this in my makeup kit, and I find that I do use this a lot, which is why this ranks pretty high. But on myself, these just aren't my preferable tones, but it does have a lot of the basic shades that you need, as well as extra shades to really change up a look. This was revolutionary for its time. It was unique. It was different. Now everything is warm, but yeah, so this is more of just a personal thing for me, where I just prefer neutral tones, so. Alright, so let's move on to palette number three, which is the Sultry palette. So if you recall, a few months ago, I went back and forth with purchasing this when it first came out, just because I felt as though the colors weren't very unique and that I had them, but ultimately, of course, I decided to pick them up because I can't help myself, and this ended up being one of my favorite ABH palettes. I love the tones in this. It's a little bit more cool tone, which is the complete opposite from the Modern Renaissance, and these are more my tones. This is a pretty easy palette to use. You don't have to think about the looks too often, and it is just, these shimmers are so beautiful. I didn't think I would like this palette as much as I did end up liking it, just because I really can create some sultry looks. The name of this is very good. Really soft, glam, sultry looks. The best thing to do with this palette, in my opinion, is to get a really dark matte base and then really go in with one of these metallic shades all over the lid, and it's just so gorgeous. And I really feel like the formula of this is really exceptional as well. A little tidbit here, I feel like the new Urban Decay palette that just released, I believe it's called the Reloaded or something like that, very reminiscent of this palette. Does anybody else get those vibes? So if you're curious, I will not be purchasing that Urban Decay palette because it literally looks like this to me. And I mean, this one though gets best packaging award for sure. This is the most pretty palette ever. All right, so palette number two, this is an oldie, but it is a goodie. This is the Master palette by Mario. So a couple of years ago, ABH, they collaborated with Mario, who is Kim Kardashian's makeup artist. Now, I don't have a look to show you just because I never did a look with this, so I actually used this palette today just so you can at least get an idea of the kind of look I would create with it. And I just created this really gorgeous bronze smoky eye. I just think the tones that he chose in this palette really complements everybody. This is a palette that you don't have to think about at all when you're using it. It's very user friendly. You can create the most gorgeous looks without thinking about it. So this palette, when I look at it, it looks very boring to me because they're kind of all a similar tone. They all are basically a satin finish with the exception of like two, but that's what makes it so easy to use. You get a beautiful look no matter what you do. You can put all of these colors on your eyes at once and I think the look would be gorgeous. It wouldn't be too muddy. It's very unfortunate that this palette was limited edition because it's good. And I don't know if it's just me, but I feel like this is the best quality palette ABH has ever made as well. Call me crazy, but every time I use this palette, I just feel like I have like sexy eyes. I hadn't used this palette in a while, so today was the first day I picked it up in a while and I fell in love with it all over again. But it just makes me sad to use this because I can't get it if like I ever run out. Not that I would ever use up a whole palette, but wow, this is such a banging palette. All right, so let's move on to my number one most favorite palette from ABH. This should come as no surprise because I don't shut up about this palette, the Soft Glam. In my opinion, this is like my favorite everyday eyeshadow palette in my entire collection. It just has every color that I need to create an everyday look, a nighttime look. It's not the most fun palette to look at, but it really is the most usable for me, the most versatile for me. I can throw this in my makeup travel bag and feel okay with every shade in this palette and not feel like I need to pull in another palette. It has a cream shade that I love, many different transition shades that I can build up for different types of depths and looks. and then a nice array of really neutral, pretty colors for the lid. I don't know, I just feel like this is just the perfect everyday palette. Love the quality of it. It's very smooth, very blendable. I will say ABH formula, in my opinion, it is a bit too powdery for my preference. I just don't like that mess. I'm one of those people who don't really like fallout, but I can work with it because I do always get a beautiful result. So I do want to mention that about the formula just so you guys know how I work and what my preferences are. So ABH actually doesn't have my favorite formula, but the looks are always beautiful that I come up with, so I'm not mad about it. And like I said, the way they lay out these palettes and the colors, best in the business, honestly. Every color you need, I just feel so comfortable using ABH palettes, so inspired, and I mean, her eyeshadow palettes are so popular for a reason. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this rankings video. Let me know down below if there's anything else you would like to see me rank. If you're curious about anything that I'm wearing on my face right now, it will be linked down in the description box. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you found it helpful if you were looking into purchasing your first ABH palette. And I will see you guys in the next video. Remember to subscribe. Bye guys. Have a great day.